Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS with a LEGO Superheroes set review. This is from the DC Universe, the Superman sets. This is the Battle of Smallville from 2013, set number 76003, and officially it is coming with 418 pieces. So I've got it all built here. Let's go ahead and take a look at what comes with it, starting with the minifigures. Right off the bat, I can say that I think that this is the set to get if you're a fan of LEGO and a fan of Superman, especially the most recent Man of Steel one, or even Superman 2 that's, you know, basically following the same part of the storyline. This is the one that has the right characters in all of them. You've got Superman himself, you've got General Zod, you've got Feyre, and you've got Tor-An, and then this set also includes in Colonel Hardy over here from the Man of Steel 2013 movie release. And there are plenty of sites out there that will really focus on giving you the highest quality photos of the minifigures and such, so there's plenty of research that you can do if you want to really go into detail on these. I don't want to take up too much time, because I want to show the rest of the stuff in the set, but I do want to show you that three of these characters do have alternate faces on their heads. Superman, General Zod, and Feyre all have different faces, and Superman and General Zod have the red laser eyes in their alternate form on the head on the back. These two don't have alternate heads, but you do have some other options for two of these. Zod and his gal get Kryptonian armor, which can be either put on or taken off. And I really like these pieces. You can see that they fit over the neck and over the cape, and they integrate in really well. Put a little curve on the top of the cape. Makes it look very, very evil and a little bit regal. I especially like the one on Zod. You've got three colors there with black, gunmetal gray, and then the nice bright silver color too. Just really, really nice looking mold. Not too bulky, and looks good, I think, from all angles. Of course, it's not gonna work so well with these two-sided heads. Actually, that's an interesting look. If you're into Star Wars, you know, you can kind of make some old Sith characters with that kind of look. That's an interesting thought. But these armor pieces are designed to be used with the helmets, so you can put the helmets on there, and that gives you a third look. So good deal. With, you know, these two are exactly the same mold and the same print, but gives a slightly different look with the different armor designs. Really cool. I think that worked out really, really well. You've got extra detail even on the back too, so they went kind of above and beyond with the detail on these helmets. I really like these minifigures. I think it's a nice core feature of the set, even though they're small little things. Now Colonel Hardy gets himself a Jeep, and this is such a simple build. Has a very small part count thanks to the use of this unified single piece center section of the vehicle. I'll go ahead and put the Colonel in his spot there, but it looks like exactly what it's trying to be. It's a little bit on the rugged side with the use of the larger sized tires that really increases playability, makes it easy to drive this over bumps and over carpet and such. And then you've got a turret on the back with the pair of flick missiles. Only thing that's not so great about that is that you have to hold it carefully in order to get the flick action in there, but that's a tiny little thing. It's just a simple build. They've got some studs on the side, action going on the bed section as well as on the grill, and it's just done right. You know, it's not using up a ton of pieces, taking pieces away from the main thing in the set, and I think it just looks really good. Now here's the drop ship. And this is the major thing that you build in the entire set. I'll just give this a little rotation so you can see it from some different angles. This is really nice looking. They used a really clever use of parts, I think, using not too many parts. It's not too difficult of a build, you know, even for younger builders. It does have a fair number large parts on it, even keeping the parts count down, and they really captured the overall look of the dropship. I think really well. I think it's a very successful design. And then down here you've got the cannons. It can rotate around. There's no up and down, but it does rotate. And there is action in here too, because you can see they use two of these Technic cannons. There's one here. There's one here. These are really good weapons for playability. You can easily grab this from the back and access those two triggers for shooting those out. I think that's really awesome. These are difficult to lose. They're not so small like flick missiles where they'll roll out of the way. I think this system for shooting stuff is really good. You've got opening cockpit here with space for two. Frown face, only two. So Zod and Feyor go in there. Got a little control panel there. No space for Toran, sorry. But you know, I showed you the two minifigures. They have a lot of stuff, right? They've got the armor. They've got the capes. They've got the little Kryptonian blasters here. I forgot to really point out, but a lot of that stuff ideally needs to come off before you put the figures into the cockpit. So they gave you space to do that. They gave you space to store some stuff here, space to store some stuff here, and these are actually hinges which can bend down, and you can stick both Kryptonian blasters in there. Very nice, very neat, holds them in there. They're not going to fall out, they're not going to rattle around. And then you can put some of the armor pieces over here if you want them to not be using the armor. The capes, not such a great idea to fold up the capes and try to put those in there. But you know, you can either just set the characters down in the cockpit with their capes, or take the capes off completely and just leave them separately, because you do need to move the capes out of the way to really attach your figures to the base down there. I like this thing. I'm very, very satisfied with it. It's pretty sturdy for a Lego creation. The things that can come off easily or that are a little bit dangerous, I think, are just these. The antennae that kind of stick up here, you know, those can fall off. That's pretty just normal stuff. Also, kids got to watch out for their eyes with those. They're kind of pointed directly at your eyes, but just don't bring it too close to your head. Other than that, pretty good, pretty solid, sturdy build. One other action here, tiny bit of disappointment in that this doesn't do like the one in the movie where it lands just on these and just sits on them only. Once you put these little wingtip bits down, it's not really going to hold itself up. I can try to find a spot there. It'll just balance, but it really wants to tip forward. So if you want to get, you know, if you're storing it on the shelf or something, you can pull off that look. But for general play, it's generally not going to work out all that well. This was the first minifig scaled superhero set that I reviewed, and I'm really glad that I chose this one, because like I said, it's the one that you want to get from Superman to get these really cool figures with really nice accessories on them too. And you get a great looking ship too, plus extra Jeep, and there's functionality, there's playability, there's action, there are things that can change and move around, and it goes with the story, and they also give you a little comic book that's also included as a yet another bonus. It's $50 US for the set, as the standard retail price. Given the number of parts, you know, it's 418 parts. A lot of the parts are not tiny. I think that it's a good value. It's a good value based on the parts themselves. I think it's a good value based on what you get and the playability, especially with the cool minifigures. I'm just really happy with it overall. You know, I nitpick on small things, but you know, I point out the things that I like and the things that I don't like, but overall I do like this set very much, and I'm happy to have had the opportunity to review it for all of you. So thank you very much for following along and watching this review, and I've got more coming, so stay tuned and come back for more. Talk to you again soon.